Tonight's game, this one promises to be a good one between the Indiana Hoosiers and the Purdue Boilermakers. And, of course, we look here at our star watch. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
I'm really excited about the matchup at the power forward position. When they play well, their respective teams usually play well. Let's see what happens tonight.
This game is definitely about rivalry. Let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews.
Brad and Dick, these two rivals have been waiting to get it on for a long time. Now we get another opportunity to see who's better. All the banter will stop now, and it's all about performing. Who will step up and lead their team onto a victory? These games seem to always have a story. Stay tuned as we track this one from start to finish.
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team and our sideline reporter, keeping us up to date with what's taking place behind the scenes and around the bench. Good job, EA. And now, getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work. Got to think right now, got to focus defensively.
Now trying to feed the low block. Number two picks up the foul. First team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, by the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's a matter of bringing it every day.
You can't miss free throws, Dick. It's going to kill you somewhere down the line.
Well, you got to convert. That's the one thing, like football, special situations. You got to be able to execute there.
Free throw is good. They've got him right where they want him, Dick.
Stepping it, man. Take a look right here. Little Baryshnikov in shorts. Little ballerina hanging in the air.
He's a jack of all trades. They work it around the perimeter. Buries it home. To get it to the inside. In the lane, the missed shot. Edwards handles the feed.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
For the bucket, off the glass and no good. Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nessler. We got a good one going. And a slam. Edwards receives the pass. Jumper knocks it down. Johnson receives the ball.
Double team now, bad angle.
And it's knocked loose.
Look at that spacing.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
He buries the shot. Jumper won't go. On the dribble, gives it up from the corner. Nope.
Shooter spotting up on a three.
Gave it up. Tries for two. Too strong. The shooting guard takes the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land. An errant pass out of bounds for the turnover.
Well, you credit that to two factors. One, great team defense, but number two, lack of communication offensively, not in rhythm and sync.
The other way. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
The Hoosiers with the push. Johnson handles the pass. He draws a foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
A chance for two. Gets it. Strong rebound, and now looking to move it down court in a hurry.
Men have got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
Takes the pass in the paint. Goes up with a shot. Missed it. Number two takes the pass. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Drains it. They work the perimeter. Goes up for two. Nope. There they come with a double team to stop it. And we'll head back down to the other end. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
Working it around the perimeter. He tries the three. They're having a real tough time hitting from the floor.
These guys have hit rock bottom. Their confidence at the moment couldn't be any lower.
Both teams looking to get things going here. The Hoosiers are getting some great opportunities to score when they get the ball in the high post.
They got into one of the most valuable parts of the court, Mr. Nestler. The high post is a gold mine if you can make the right decisions with the ball.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Let's it fly. And yet another missed field goal attempt, Dick.
Hey, when you get in a funk like this, you've got to get a few gimmies, some layups, something that's going to get your rhythm back and give you the confidence to shoot from the perimeter.
Let's go back and take a look at this one again, Dick.
Oh, Mr. Nestler, that's how you throw it down.
They work it around the perimeter. For two, he gets it to go. On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Obvious foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket. You know, seniors are a dying breed in college basketball these days. If you're a coach that's lucky enough to have a couple, it can definitely help you sleep at night knowing there are guys on your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful.
got them both. Fed the low block. He tries the jumper. Nails the J. On the outside. With the jumper. And nice looking jumper in the lane. Dumps it in. Takes his jumper. Missed the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. If you call for it, he may throw it to you, too. Currently, this is how things look in conference play. And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up with it. Can't connect. Thompson receives the ball. Gave it up. Puts up the jumper.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
They'll work it around the arc. Track, there's the rejection. Receives the pass.
The freshman's a bit careless with the ball.
Puts up the J. They're not doing a very good job of finding the hoop tonight, Dick.
Well, they're not working the ball around. They're not finding the open man. Turnover by the senior.
The Boilermakers in transition. They've got a player spotting up on the three.
Wow, that was a classic alley-oop. Hey, the finger went up in the air before the screen was set.
Loose ball saved. That goes out of bounds, and we'll stay at this end. All right, let's go courtside to Aaron Andrews regarding the rivalry between these two teams. Aaron, I got to think you can really feel it over there. Rivalry games are big, and you've got a great seat.
Well, this is very typical of a rivalry game. The score is close, and neither team wants to back down. We'll have to continue to monitor this and see what unfolds.
Aaron Andrews, our sideline correspondent. All of you know that with an additional insight there. Receives the ball. He's going to see this guy in his sleep tonight, Dick.
He's already living the nightmare, Brad.
For the bucket. There was no doubt about that one. The power forward receives the ball. Turnaround jumper. Off the mark. Johnson receives the ball.
Coach looks on. Focused. A lot of intensity. A lot of emotion.
Trying to feed the low block. He wants a three. And come up short. trying to feed inside. About 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Thompson receives the pass. He shoots from outside. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. And back they come the other way. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. He gets the bucket. Top of the circle, nails the jumper. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. For two, knocked it down. Nick, they're really running their offense through the high post right now.
You know, it's a good offense when you can position a player at the high post and then have the ball delivered to a scoring threat.
Trying to pack it inside. Let's watch the move as he works his man and out a fadeaway jumper. On the left side. Looking for a good shot. Jumper, the missed shot. On the dribble, gives it up. About 7 minutes, and it's blocked. Number one is down emotionally right now, Dick.
Well, he knows he's not getting it done, and emotionally, it's bringing him down. Up and inside.
Tries for two. Not this time. On the right side. He goes up with it, scores it. Looking for a good shot. For the bucket, got it. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. About 6 minutes remaining. On the inside, goes up for two. He comes up empty. Edwards receives the pass. He attempts the jump shot.
Excellent jump shot right there.
On the outside, he puts it up, doesn't go. Number 31 takes the pass. For two, he can't get the bucket to fall. He puts up the J, missed the jumper. The small forward gets the ball. Now they work it around the perimeter. Tries for two, sinks it. Gave it up. To pick up the defense here now. You betcha.
You gotta let the offense play into the double.
Yeah, they may be forcing the double a little bit. Out on the right wing.
Trying to go inside.
Goes up. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
the perimeter. We're at the 4 minute mark. For the bucket. Great shot. A little two man action.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Goes up for two. Gets it to fall. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
Two teams are picking and choosing where they want to push the ball, Brad. Look at that spacing.
For two, drains the shot. About 3 minutes remaining. And a momentary look from three-point land. Tries for two. Shots off the mark. For the bucket. Off the mark. As the fans chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage? Shot though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior. Good drive right there. Good penetration.
They work the perimeter. Goes up for two. Knocks it down. Job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Shoots it. Shot off. Taylor receives the ball. They go into the low block. He pulls up with a jumper. Knocks it down. Way out on top. Controlling the ball for two. Not there. Number 31 gets the pass. Down inside. Takes the shot. And he missed. About a minute remaining in the game clock. Working it around the perimeter. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebounding ability.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Jumper won't go. Stop and pop. Can't get the shot to go. Comes up short. On the dribble, gives it up. Jumper. Nope.
Good rebound. Great position on a rebound. Good block out. As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
At the half. The Boilermakers are up by one. And here's our game summary.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who's been doing what.
Quickly checking back in.
They need him out there, Brad, just like I need you, man. This guy is the glue.
Let's go courtside for a comment regarding this rivalry. Aaron?
Well, Brad, this game has been full of emotion, and for now, the second half is about channeling that energy so that the performance isn't compromised. The first half is in the book, so watch for execution and team play to really step up.
Our trusty sideline reporter, Aaron Andrews, keeping everyone on their toes there on the sideline. They work it around the perimeter. Tries for two. It sticks. On the outside. For the bucket. Knocked it down. Gave it up. We'll take the shot. In and out. Moving it around the perimeter.
Silly mistake.
Up for two. Off the glass and no good. Arm and foul. Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
The jumper off the mark. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He shoots the jumper. Nails the jumper. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Inside. Takes his jumper. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
He's doing it all right now for this team. It'll be interesting to see if he can keep this up. Block shot usually creates momentum and opportunity.
Great hustle. Edwards handles the feed. Looking for a good shot. Turnaround jumper. The missed shot.
Up and inside.
Stolen away. The Boilermakers are on the run. Alley-oop for two.
Look at that. That's unbelievable, baby.
Dick, when I see those types of things, I just get chills.
Listen to that roar. It's unbelievable.
He goes up with it. Busts the J. Looking for a good shot. Goes up with it. Missed it.
He's got hops like you, man. He got hops like you.
It is pretty similar.
Wow. didn't realize my partner was a high riser.
On the dribble, gives it up. The jump shot and come up short. Way out on the right wing. Inside. He strokes it. Perfectly executed. He puts up the J. Jumper won't go. As we continue to track the game's tempo,
these teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Gave it up. He throws it up from downtown, scores it. Isolated on the outside, they're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Off the mark. On the right side. On the outside. He fires it up. Doesn't go. Tries for two. Oh, yes. Pause in the action. More NCAA basketball coverage coming up right after this. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player. Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
Working around the perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. Nails the J. Cross court. Puts up the J.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
On the wing. Goes up with a shot. They get it to go. He can't stay with him.
He's got to get some help from his teammates on D.
Johnson receives the ball. For the bucket, sinks the shot. How about that drive to the hoop, Dick?
When you drive with conviction, good things happen. Sometimes it's the basket, sometimes you get fouled.
He shoots the jumper. Off the mark. Number two takes the pass. They work it around the perimeter. And we're going the other way. These guys have really been able to step it up so far, and they're putting together a very good team effort.
It's been great to watch them move the ball like that, and they're doing all the things it takes to win. They're committed to playing good team defense, and when your team is doing those type of things, you're smiling as a coach.
We've got two rivals here. Let's go to our sideline reporter, Aaron Andrews. Aaron? Aaron, I think you can feel the crowd's reaction to this game. Good first half, and this rivalry matchup stayed that way here in the second half.
Just as expected, rivals refuse to back down from each other, and it's obvious here today. Bragging rights are definitely on the line tonight, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. He looks for three. Missed it. Not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough. And a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Here comes the ball screen. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Edwards handles the pass. Now trying to feed the low block with the J. Missed the jumper. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. For two, that was nice. A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
I tell you, he's really attacking the goal. He's going in fearless, and he's absolutely attacking the defense.
Dribble, gives it up, takes the jumper, and scoring. Johnson receives the pass.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
Basic.
Goes up. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
Turnover committed by the senior. The Boilermakers in transition. Momentary look from three-point land. From the corner, scorches the net with a J. Tries for two, gets it to go. Heading out of bounds. No, great save. The Boilermakers are in a great position with the time and score on their side, and they're going to have to play more in the half court now, Dick.
Yeah, I think the best thing to do at this point is to slow completely down at the offensive end. If you have transition opportunities, take them. Otherwise, milk the clock and shoot with less than 7 seconds left on the clock.
They look to get it to the inside. Puts up the jumper. They got it. Cross court. And the fans here are loving the action.
Hey, this place is remarkable. The noise is deafening.
Knocks it down. Nice shot. Well, let's take a look at the tempo each team is going to try to set for this game, Richard.
Well, whenever you have two teams looking to control the speed of the game, you need to keep your eye on how each team makes changes. Setting the tempo can be an advantage, but adapting can be just as important.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. He shoots from the deep corner. In and out. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Let's watch the move as he works his man and not a fadeaway jumper. Fed the low block. He unloads. Perfectly executed. Cross court. 6 minutes left on the game clock. He misses the J. Bryant receives the ball. Dumps it in. Rejected. Nails the J. Cross court. Jumper. Nails a sweet jumper. Haas handles the feed. Kicks it out. About 5 minutes remaining in the game clock. Trying to feed the low block. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. Blocked. Gave it up. He shoots from the top of the circle. Nails the jumper. They work the perimeter. That's why I love this game, Dick, for that reason alone.
Oh, I couldn't agree with you more, Mr. Nessler. We are so lucky that we get to go to all these schools and experience the mayhem firsthand.
Working it around the perimeter. Jumper. The shot's off target. About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Goes up for two. With the layup. On the dribble, gives it up. Nice shot. Cross court. He tries a three ball. He misses the jumper. Yes! A little two-man action. They work it around the perimeter. We're at the three-minute mark. Number three receives the pass. Trying to pack it inside. For two. Was that beautiful or what? On the outside. I think he was there, Dick.
Yeah, but that could have gone either way.
Dick, I've heard you talk about this a million times before. How about the number of baskets that have been scored in the paint here?
They keep going inside because they feel as though they've got an advantage there. They're really exposed to weak defense in the paint, but it's got to continue. They must continue to play in the same manner.
moving it around the perimeter. He blocks the shot. Trying to feed inside. Here's a double team. Can't connect. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. They'll work it around the arc. Puts it up. Perfectly executed. 7 points right now is the difference in this one.
Hey, Brad, 7 points is no safe haven. You got to keep pressing.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. The lead is 9.
9 is fine, Brad. They have to keep their composure and take good shots.
Looking for a good shot. Takes his jumper. Busts the jumper. Puts up the J.
Excellent jump shot right there.
About a minute remaining. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? They're set to throw it in from the side. And the clock stopped with a foul. The offense begins off the sideline inbounds. He tries to knock down the three. They're punishing the rim with those misses from three-point lane.
Yeah, Brad, no one seems to have found the touch.
Time out on the floor, folks. More ESPN coverage coming up right after this. Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. Out on the wing.
Up and inside.
He attempts the three. Gets the J to fall. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Clock stop with a foul. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And the clock stop with a foul. Purdue is in the bonus. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
I like it when a team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
He hits the second. Well, the lead is 10, Dick. Are you starting to hear the fat lady?
Well, Brad, she could be warming up right now.
And the clock stopped with a foul. And here's a look at the first-year play.
You know, playing at this level can be a tough adjustment for some kids. Others make the jump look easy. It all depends on what kind of team you have around you and how hard you are willing to work to get better.
Misses the second shot. Pushes it. He shoots from the top of the circle. Shot clock is dead. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Chance for an easy one. Gets it. No doubt.
That'll take some pride out of the defensive end.
Looking for a good shot. He puts up the three ball. He misses the J. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. Dick, all the hype and hoopla prior to this rivalry game, and it didn't pan out the way we expected, really.
Well, everybody was really keyed up, expected a great game, but they got the great start early, and that was it. It was blowout city.